From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Norm Karkos. Members of the state legislature reconvened this morning, and at the top of their agenda, the DHHS budget. Protesters who say proposed cuts will hurt Mainers were at the state house to greet the returning lawmakers. News 8's Dave Guthrow is there.
I'm News 8's Dave Guthrow inside the State House in Augusta. Of course, the legislature reconvening today. And as you can see, a number of special interest groups, including the Maine Women's Lobby, protesting inside the State House. They formed a line between the Senate and the House of Representatives. And they're standing up against a variety of proposed cuts to programs that help women, children, and seniors, including drugs for the elderly, the Medicare Savings Program, Medicare, Head Start, and several others. Organizers saying that they're here to make sure that lawmakers know these proposed cuts will have a drastic impact. And of course, we'll have full coverage throughout the day on our website, WMTW.com.
U.S. Coast Guard has terminated the voyage of a Maine-based commercial fishing vessel for allegedly having no life jackets on board. The Coast Guard says a team conducted a routine inspection of the 38-foot fishing vessel Calypso on Monday and found several safety violations. They were allegedly no personal flotation devices, no visual distress signals, and no life rings aboard. All are required by law. The Coast Guard terminated the crew's voyage and escorted the vessel back to Port Korea. The state has rolled out upgrades to its official website. Governor Paula Page highlighting enhancements which include a more responsive design, a faster search engine, and improved speed even on mobile devices. LePage says the improvements also provide government transparency and efficiency. Thanks for tuning in to this News 8 Now update. I'm Norm Karkos. Make sure to check out other top stories of the day on our website at WMTW.com. Have a great day.